welcome to another video from my room here in Lima, Peru. So today I'm here to share with you guys a little bit of my Peruvian culture. A few days ago, I was just thinking about myself and my Chinese trip and how I decided to share with you guys my trips, my experiences, and the Chinese culture in general. So I asked myself, why am I not doing the same thing with my very own culture? So for that reason, I decided to share with you guys today a few Christmassy traditions that we all Peruvians have, particularly people from Lima, which is the capital of Peru, which is the place where I am from. So with that being said, let's just get to the video. The very first thing I'm gonna talk about, guys, is religion. The majority of Peruvians are Catholic, although there are many people that consider themselves Catholics, but they don't really practice Catholicism. I'm not here to give you a whole lecture of Catholicism, okay? But let's just say that my family is Catholic, so I am Catholic too. And because of that, we have this thing called the Advent wreath or the Advent crown, which is pretty much a circumference of garland with four candles on it. During the Advent season, which is 4 weeks before Christmas, one candle is lit each Sunday as a spiritual preparation for the coming of Jesus. So every Sunday the family gathers together to sing, to pray, and we also have a goal that we have to achieve during that week. For example, be kind, be forgiving, just do something good for another person. I really like the Advent season and December in general because all the family gathers together, which is something very difficult to do throughout the year because, you know, everybody is busy and that's understandable. But December in general is just to be together, to give love, to be kind, and it's a good reminder that we are all here in this world to be good, to do good, and also that there is a good person here deep inside of us. We all know that Christmas is on December the 25th, but in Peru, and I believe in many countries, the celebration starts the day before, which is December the 24th. So that day, people wake up super early to go to the malls to buy their last minute presents. So you can see lots of cars just passing by all the time, many people just walking around in the streets, selling firecrackers, going to the restaurants to bake their turkeys and all that, and that's super fun. And I think I can even say that the 24th of December is the most active day of the whole year. So talking about turkeys, I believe now it's time to talk about my favorite subject, which is food. Many countries have their own Christmassy dishes, and in case of Peru, we eat turkey or pork as a main course. We also eat rice, which is kind of common, I believe. Pretty much every single Peruvian dish comes with rice. But there's this special rice called kind of Arabian rice. I don't really know if the name has something to do with Arabic countries, but come on, that rice is so good, and we only eat it on Christmas. So every Christmas, we have to wait like a whole year to eat the rice again. It has pecans, noodles, raisins, and also bacon. It's like a chow fun, like a Chinese chow fun, you know, a mixture of things, but believe me, it's so good. Then we also have our Christmassy salad, which is an apple salad. We have sweet potato puree, we have apple puree, and we also have panettone or panettone in Italian, which is kind of a cake originally from Italy, but somehow we just made it Peruvian style, but it's good too. If you don't have it in your country, you should definitely try it. We also have hot chocolate, and last but not least, of course, we have the champagne to make the toast. I'm really sorry if this video turns out to be like super bad, but can you hear that? There's a dog crying all the way here. Of course, that makes me sad, but I'm also annoyed because this camera catches the sounds from everywhere. So you can hear the cars just passing by because I live in front of the street, and also the dog, and it's just driving me crazy, okay? So we all know that Christmas is for the family to be together, to be happy and all that. So now I think it's time for me to explain how I spend the 24th of December. To make this story short, we wake up super early. Well, super early to me because I wake up at 9 a.m. Then we go to a restaurant to ask somebody else to bake our turkey. Yeah, let's just say that I'm not a cooker. I'm more like an eater kind of person. Well, I kind of don't know how to bake a turkey, but after that, we go back home, we have lunch, and after we have lunch, we go to my grandma's house, and we wait till 10 o'clock, because at 10 o'clock, the midnight Christmas mass starts. So at 11 p.m., we go back to my grandma's house, And then it's almost Christmas, so we're all super excited, we're all super happy. Yeah, I believe you kind of picture it, right? So I'm in charge of turning on the radio, so every single radio station has this countdown. We have 30 minutes left until Christmas. We have 10 minutes left. 5, 4, 3, 2. Yeah, we have the countdown, which is like the best thing to do. So we hear the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Merry Christmas! After that, we all start to hug each other to say Merry Christmas, and then we gather together again around the nativity set. Of course, Jesus Christ is born, so we all have to pray first. After we pray and we hug each other and we are all happy, just dancing around and all that, we even go outside because we can see fireworks and firecrackers everywhere, and it's kind of cool. Then it's finally the time to make the toast. So we gather together again around the table. We grab our glasses of champagne and we make the toast. So we cheers to cheers, with everybody. And I kind of don't like champagne, but I kind of do it for the toast. Now I'm gonna talk about the gift culture that Peruvians have. To explain myself a little better, I think it's the perfect time now to take my camera and take you guys to my Christmas tree. Tree made the guys, guys made a tree. So here we have my Christmas cards that I showed in a previous video. And here we have the empty boxes that I also showed in a previous video. So here we have my empty gift bag. Here we have like a random empty bottle. We have a random toilet paper roll, random box, and another random box. So yeah, zero presents in here. Now that I've shown you my tree, I think you can finally understand a little better. Our gift culture is not that as big as they have it in America. Christmas presents are mainly for children because they have this pretty illusion of Santa giving presents to everybody. So it's not that mandatory for adults, you know? But of course, if you work and if you have the money, you can give presents to whoever you want. Now we're back to my favorite subject again, which is food. Of course, we have dinner. Where it's not actually dinner, but it's kind of like a dinner slash breakfast, because we have dinner, the Christmas dinner, very late at around 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. So poor stomach. But yeah, we have like a huge fest that's almost like a buffet, and it's huge, and we eat a lot, and we're Peruvians, and we have to prepare our stomachs to eat a lot that day. The next day, which is December the 25th, of course, everybody wakes up super late, so there's no morning. We only wake up in the afternoon, and we have only afternoon and night, and that's pretty much it. So the 25th is mainly just to rest and to eat all the leftovers. I forgot to mention, you get to eat the leftovers for the next 3 or 4 days. Then you go to church again, and you go back, you're with your family once again, and that's pretty much it. Now with the facts, we all know this old man who wears red every single Christmas, okay? It's Santa, of course, but please, don't call him Santa in Peru. I believe in every part of Latin America, everybody calls him no Santa, no Saint Nicholas, but Papa Noel. So if you come to a Latin American country on Christmas, please don't ask a child, what is Santa Claus going to give you for Christmas? No, because he's not going to understand you. Please ask him, what is Papa Noel going to give you? That way, he will totally understand. Another fact that I think it's very important to point out is that we all have this amazing concept of the white, the snowy Christmas, just sitting super near to the fireplace, super warm. No, that's never gonna happen in Peru, because in Peru, Christmas is in the summer. Come on, I'm boiling hot in here. But no, it doesn't matter that we are in the summer, we still drink hot chocolate, because that's part of the Peruvian tradition. Can you believe that? Drinking hot chocolate in the summer? Come on! And for that exact reason, I think now it's kind of obvious to mention it, but we also don't have an ugly Christmas sweater. Another fact concerns the stockings. As it is with presents, which pretty much depend on the family, we kind of don't have stockings, actually. So if you come here, you don't have to worry about the stocking stuffers. More than a fact, this is kind of a curious thing to know. The Christmas carols are not the same in each country. We don't listen to Frosty the Snowman. Instead, we listen to another fact concerns Christmas trees. Of course, we don't have natural Christmas trees, but instead we use artificial ones, which is something I totally support because, of course, you're not cutting out a living thing, but instead you're buying an artificial thing that will last for the next 10 years. The last fact is very serious and I think it's very important to mention in this video. A few years ago, in the year 2001 to be exact, there was a very big fire. A spark from a firework demonstration caused a chain reaction in a very big shopping mall in the center of Lima. Almost 300 people died, and for that reason the government prohibited the use of fireworks and firecrackers. Every single year in December, Peruvians remember this incident as a reminder that we all have to be careful with what we hold in our own hands. Unfortunately, there are many people that only care about the money and not other people's safety. At the time, for example, most of the fireworks were sold illegally, and that's what caused the accident. I think I kind of support the prohibition of fireworks in some way. The animals, for example, during these holidays, they suffer a lot because of the explosions and they can even die. So I think that if we take these things seriously and in a very responsible way, we can make this world better. Okay guys, so this is it for this video. I really hope you guys learned something new from my country today. If you are from a different country than me, please tell me in the comment section which traditions your very own country has. I will be more than glad to read your comments. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also follow me on Instagram and don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you want to keep hearing from me. So this is it for this video. I really hope you guys like it and please look forward to the next one. Bye bye.